Good morning, Calvert Hall. I'm Matthias Pridgen.
I'm Cameron Harris.
Today is Thursday, October 5th, a day one on your schedule. Please stand for the prayer and the pledge. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear God, in a world facing poverty, misfortune, and disease, I think it is essential to thank you for what I do have. Thank you for the beautiful nature in which I wake up every day. Thank you for a family that I can always lean on for support. Thank you to my friends who make each day special enough to get up for the next. Thank you for guiding me thus far through my life and being there through it all. Most importantly, thank you for life. Help me to recognize your presence more fully in mine. Amen. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please remain standing for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
General, schedule today. CHC is on a late arrival schedule today. Classes are 30 minutes in length with dismissal at 2:45. Homeroom tomorrow. All students should meet in assembly seats tomorrow for the magazine drive treasure hunt. You'll need 5 sales by tomorrow to take the box or the cash if your name is called. Prizes on the scanner. If you have an RFID tag, make sure to scan it every day on the Cardinal Bird in the dining hall to see if you won cash, candy, free lunch, free pizza, tickets to the Harvest Dance, or more. Mascot. We're looking to train up a few guys to be the bird at sporting events, tradition events, turkey bowl, and more. If you think you make a great bird, email Mr. Parisi. We'll have a meeting in the coming weeks to train you up. No experience needed, only enthusiasm and CHC spirit. Mass. Friday is First Friday. Mass will be offered in the chapel at 7:45 a.m. Join us as we welcome Father Jim Prophet, Director of Clergy Personnel for the Archdiocese, as the celebrant and homilist. Commons closing early. The Commons will close at 3:45 tomorrow, October 6th, for an event. Orange Friday. Wear your O's jersey or O's t-shirt over your shirt and tie and in place of your sport coat on Friday, as we support the O's in their pursuits in the postseason. If you are dressed down for the magazine drive, you may just wear the jersey or the t-shirt. College visits. The following colleges will be visiting in the school counseling office: Shenandoah University, 1010, period 1. Washington College, 1120, period 3. Gettysburg College, 1230, period 5. And Ohio State University, 140, period 7. Now let's get a quick update on house rankings.
Good morning, Luke.
Good morning, Mr. Matze.
I think everyone would like to know, what's the latest update on the house competition?
I think that's a great question, and a lot of people are curious. So far, the standings are strong in first place, followed by a four-way tie between DeNoto, Newman, Maselli, and Rogers. Then, Cavalier, Clary, Freitag, Kropp, and Sterner bring up the bottom.
But what about the competition for points with the magazine drive?
Well, the magazine drive isn't over until next week, but we did run the number of sales after sales closed on Tuesday to see how things looked. Based on those numbers, there would be some shakeups in the standings. If the numbers stood as they are, it looks like Rogers could move into the lead.
Are you saying Strong House drops to second, but the rest of the houses stay the same?
Not at all. In fact, after Strong in second place, it could be a tie in third between DeNoto and Maselli. Then Clary and Sterner come up at sixth place. Newman falls to seventh place, and Cavalier, Kropp, and Freitag round out the bottom three.
That's quite a change in standings for some of the houses.
It really is. But it's not all settled, and we have several more days to go in the magazine drive. Anything can happen in the next few days with guys selling their magazines. We have posted the current group totals on every group page so you can see where your house stands.
So here's the deal. We will do points for the house with the most total money brought in sales. We're also going to give points for the house with the most participants. So there is an incentive now for your house to get guys who haven't sold anything to make just one sale. The houses are all within 10 points or so, so getting 5 to 7 or even 10 new guys to participate in your house could make all the difference. We've posted those totals on your group page as well, so be sure to check it out in the On Campus.
So that's the story so far. Everyone should get involved and go out there and sell your magazines. Help the school and earn points for your house.
That's all from us in Magazine Drive Central. Have a great day, Calvert Hall.
Clubs, mic check 1212. Hispanic Council is hosting an open mic on October 10th in the Activity Center after school. The theme is Two Cultures, One Home. All welcome. Submit songs, poems, and skits to Brother Javi by October 9th. Light refreshments will be served. French Club, bonjour, Mimi. Our first meeting will be today, immediately after school. Be there. Speech and debate. Congratulations to senior Teddy Jones on getting a gold medal for best presiding officer in congressional debate. Speaking of clubs, Culinary Club sent us this delicious promotional video.
Are you tired of burning your food? Are you tired of only being able to make PB&Js? Are you tired of having to spend $20+ on carryout for something you could be making at home? Do you wish you could be in shows like Hot Ones? Do you wish you could cook or judge on MasterChef and Chopped? Do you like to eat? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you should be in the Culinary Club. Come join the Culinary Club and expand your palate today. We will be having our first meeting in the dining hall at 3 p.m. on Friday. Come with an open mind and an empty stomach. Snacks will be provided, so first come, first serve.
If you have any questions,
please contact Club President SodenD24@chcstudent.com.
Athletics, water polo. Varsity water polo picked up another conference win over Archbishop Spalding by a score of 14-11. John Zingle set the tone for a victory with 4 goals, 5 assists, and 4 steals in the field. Michael Cadley protected the net with a season high of 25 saves. And now let's send it over to Weatherman Jack for this week's weather.
Thanks, you two. Hey, Hall, I'm Weatherman Jack, and I'm back with some weather and facts. We enjoyed some nice and sunny weather these past couple days, but we unfortunately do expect some cloudy gray weather for next week, at least until Wednesday. Now, here's what's going on in our neck of the woods here on the Cardinal campus. Today, we do expect some cloudy weather, with temps being a high of 79 and a low of 65. Tomorrow, we do expect some morning showers with a high of 76 and a low of 63. We then head into some of those cool October temperatures with the weekend seeing light rain and clouds, with sun, with Saturday being a high of 66 and a low of 48. Sunday being a high of 61 and a low of 46. We then head into next week with temps staying consistent in the 60s-40 range with partly cloudy temp weather, but we do expect skies to clear up on Wednesday. That's all, Hall. Have a great day. Back to you guys.
Today's sports schedule, Fresh Soft Soccer versus Gilman, 4 o'clock home. That's not all for us today, Calvert Hall. Please stay tuned for a special message from Campus Ministry. As always, use the remaining time in homeroom to check your email.
Good morning, Calvert Hall. I'm Connor Hannon.
I'm Jack Saline.
And I'm Brendan Gardner.
And we're here to tell you more about Campus Ministry's service immersion trip offerings and our experience on the spring break immersion trip to Miami, Florida.
As you may already know, service immersion trips are periods of longer direct service with a vulnerable population in our world. Calvert Hall Campus Ministry offers several different service immersion trips throughout the second semester.
Last April, Connor, Jack, and I traveled to Homestead, Florida, which is just south of Miami, with 7 other students, Mr. Collins and Brother Javi, to serve the children and families of the South Dade Labor Camp, a small community of migrant farm worker families.
Many of the people we interacted with were migrants from Central and South America, or first-generation American-born children. As migrants, the people of the South Bay camp experience inconsistent work, language, and education barriers, as well as financial poverty.
During our time in Homestead, we mainly did tutoring and enrichment for the children of the South Bay camp, as well as physical service projects such as renovations, art installations, and food distribution.
We finished our week in sunny Miami, Florida, taking in the sights of the Everglades and Little Havana before flying back home to Baltimore.
So why should you apply for the Miami immersion trip? I'd say to get closer to your fellow students and to get outside your comfort zone.
I'd say to expand your worldview and to go deeper in LaSallian mission through service to vulnerable communities.
The trip costs $900, but if you need financial assistance, you can speak to Mr. Collins in campus ministry. The trip also counts towards junior service hours.
Campus Ministries Miami Immersion Trip runs on Calvert Health Spring Break from April 1st to April 6th, 2024, so no classes are missed for the trip.
Applications for all immersion trips will be available in the Campus Ministry office in the first week of October. Pay attention to the bulletin and announcement boards for a reminder.
There are a limited number of spots, so be sure to put your best effort into your application. Have a great day, Calvert Health.